This is the outline of the presentation. Now let's move to the lesson. And we know that the disabled people have difficulty in their life, and they are very, very difficult to control everything. So the disabled people, without hand, they cannot build the computer. It is the problem. So we should apply a solution. The solution is to design a system that for them that use the eye movement to the control computer. And the solution is called human computer interface using abstract. And if you use the video based technique, because video based technique, it is local and it just external equipment, so it don't avoid to the user. And the user can use their eye movement to control the microphone and use their eye screen to create the event. The objective and the motivation why we choose the project to research. Because we would like to improve the interaction between the human and the computer in the advanced communication. And one more, it can be speed up the working with computer using the eye interact. And the more important is it can help the disabled people in using the computer. So we hope that if the project can be used in real life, it will, the disabled people can be have a chance to use the computer after normal people. If the we have to call in this figure, it is the main overall system of eye tracking system. First, we need to be able to track the eye position and cue ball position. Cue ball is a black ball in our eye. And after we know the cue ball position, we can estimate the best position where we are looking at. After we get the best point, we can map it to the computer screen, so we can know where our eye is looking to the computer. We can use the key recognition from the coordinator of the computer to control the mouse. So after that, we see that the mouse will move to the area that we're looking to the screen computer. It is the visual feedback. In the paper, they focus only algorithm for tracking the cue ball position. This is the prototype of algorithm that tracking for the cue ball position. First, we need to have the image frame from the video. Then, we build the initial condition. Then, condition on the frame contour. And after, they use the binarization that transform the color image to the black and white image. And they use for level segmentation to provide the important component for analysis, and then apply the dark element map, and they apply the four-level segmentation event and the binarization event. Finally, the position of your can be detected by the algorithm. To test the algorithm, we need to set up the experiment. In experiment, there is a person who sits in front of the computer, and that computer should be mounted by the camera that can capture the video for analysis. There are three main experiments. One is experiment on head movement, that the person can move their head to the right, left, down, or up. And the second is experiment on the people that have the eye problem or the people who wear the glasses. And the third experiment, the experiment on how the algorithm is applied. influenced by the Indonesia. So the Indonesia is the lighting. They build the lighting, artifact lighting by the coating. And it is the result of the experiment. After the three experiments, it showed that the algorithm is robust. Because no matter the person look at to the left, right, down, or up, the algorithm still can detect and tracking the pupil position. And also, when the person is paraphrastic, the algorithm still can be detect the eye position. And one more, when we build the activator lighting, we can see that the pupil position still can operate. So we conclude that the algorithm is robust. In conclusion, this eye tracking is use the algorithm of visual processing, that the segmentation algorithm of digital image processing, and we see that the algorithm is robust because it can adapt to all the conditions. So it can be used for the real time and real life for people. Because we can see that even the person if have the sit in the background chair or they wear the plastic or they move the head movement, the algorithm still can be detect and track the eye. So in the future, this system can be used in the real life for the visible people. Because the system is local, they need only the computer and camera, and it also doesn't affect too